The operations report. More ships are repaired. Excellent. Here. Oh, we spot the DD Tanikaze. Here is where the Dauntless on scouting mission, search mission, attacked and supposedly hit it with bombs twice. VB2, bombing 2 and bombing 6 both hit it. This AKL is also hit by a Japanese aircraft. See, this is the stuff that doesn't show up in the combat report, but it does show up in the operational report, so it's necessary to check. Where the heck is this? Okay, well, we'll keep an eye on it, because they'll slow down an entire convoy if it's unknown. Here's a Catalina hitting one. Catalinas can carry torpedoes, but I guess they carry, I don't think they carry torpedoes during search missions, only on actual strike missions. The reconnaissance mission to Vigan was successful, so we did get in there. We'll see if there are any aircraft available. He's bombing from on the island, so he's moved aircraft. The little dive bombers don't have the range to fly from the mainland. Oh, well, save me the trouble, hey? Mabella, where the hell is Mabella? Okay, Mabella. Did anyone see the Mabella? Oh, here. 5347. So we'll have to take a look at that. All right, the good stuff. Improvements, expansions, more reinforcements, Cape Town, Seattle, Aden, and a Raider battalion. Oh, good. In the eastern U.S. of A. We're checking subs now. We're on Sea Lion. And look, well, she's still got two torpedoes. That's fine. We have Sea Wolf. Now, Sea Wolf, she's just one hell of a sub. She has shot herself dry. Yet she stays on patrol. That's... what is that? It's just... beyond dumb, isn't it? Here's another example. Here's S-41. All right, S-41's out here. He's got one torpedo left, but he's out of gas. Well, where are you? Is this S-40? No, it's not S-41. Here's S-41. Why would you stay out? You're out of gas. Here's Sea Lion. Okay, so Sea Lion will... no, she's still got two torpedoes at least in the front. Shark, sailfish. Here's S-41. Go back, refuel already. You want the AI to help you out to be able to do things like patrol zones so you don't move them manually. That's wonderful. But if they stay out there and commit suicide like that, how can you trust the AI? You're constantly checking, catching, checking, micromanaging it. On the subject of submarines, we're here at the base. He conducted a deliberate attack. We held him off easily. First turn. We're still building. Still burning supply. So I'm going to disband this into the base. Let's see how long it takes to repair. Whoa, two subs there. Whoa. Okay, can you hold them for 4 days, sir? Yes, we will. Well, can you hold them for 6 days? Yes, we will. We'll do what's necessary. All right. Do we have PT boats here? PT boats! Two more! Do we want to wait? Let's just disband them. Checking on ship availability. U.S. Navy. Only, please. Oh, does that mean there's 14 somewhere in the pool? Probably. But six PT boats, that's enough for us to go make trouble. Okay, Clark is in dispute, so let's set it for Bataan. This way, if Clark falls, it shouldn't, but if it does, We won't be pulling that Butuan nonsense. We'll set the first boundary right in here. Second boundary on the outside. We'll also form a subgroup. We're here already. Let's just do the sub. Oh, we have two. One undamaged. Wow. Okay. We've been really scoring well in the straits here. So, oops, oops, oops. No point, no need to fix what ain't broken. Keep flooding. We're running. We're using up the torpedoes on these guys. Form a second one. Do the same. Do a different starting point, perhaps. I'll start here instead. Same general patrol zone. By starting at a different location, they won't be covering the same hexes at the same time, I hope. All right. We're unable. We are really using up the supplies. Makes a difficult decision whether or not we should keep trying to burn it on expansion. The reason I keep burning it on expansion is if the enemy knocks one down, if we keep constructing, then we might be able to build it back up to, if he knocks it down to two, we might be able to in the middle and build it back up to three. Hence the ongoing construction. Okay, everything's up at Clark Field now. Everything here is waiting. He did a, I believe, a deliberate attack last turn, so we can't take him light, forsake him lightly. We conducted recon, and Vigan did have aircraft bombers on aircraft on it. Let's go in. Let's do it nice. Let's try to get 6,000. Will that be enough to keep us out of the major anti-aircraft? I'm hoping so. The bombers are so heavily, they're good, they're almost like good interceptors because when the enemy attack, they can't shoot them down or find it difficult to shoot them down. This P-26, gosh. We've got Catalinas and no reinforcements. No, we don't have enough reinforcements. We need 20,000 here, and that's not going to happen. The bombers here did very well, coming in at 5,000 meters. We'll do that again. Let's look at China. China. Ew. Oh, sucked us right down to nothing. We could be in trouble here. 9-4 oil. Our assault value hasn't changed much. But we do get some disruption here, probably a bomb hit. Wenchao has improved again, but we can't build on it because we're dedicating all the supply to supporting this group. We're making sure we don't cross the river here. Okay, taking our time. We've improved again here, not by much, but a little. Here we are. We're in. Go to combat. 200, 2500 assault value. He's got one unit here? Okay. We'll take it. Blast him. Any other units moved in? Nope. Checking up north. We increased strength again. Beautiful. The enemy didn't try to bomb Chongqing, interestingly enough. Let's see about the pilots that we put up here. We had the fighter pilots in. Flying a mission helps improve the experience and air skill. But I'm sure it eats up more supply than it's worth. So let's see if the enemy returns and decides to bomb us again. Nanyang got bombed. Or the troops at Nanyang got bombed. So let's go back to rest. except for the engineers. The engineers, okay, there's no anti-aircraft, or there's no anti-aircraft capability on this one. So there's no point in, yeah, we may as well try to recover it. The enemy has reappeared in the, let's see which direction he's traveling. Our anti-aircraft artillery is heading, did we get there yet? No. Hopefully next turn, we've got a couple of regiments of anti-aircraft artillery. All right, to take a look at the rest of the operations report, the Maybella was hit here and sunk. So the enemy has search aircraft up, and he's picking us off one at a time. That's just life. Life of a blockade runner. Another at Howra. Where is Howra? There was a... cavalry regiment. Where is Howra? We'll go call up the B hotkey. H... Howra. Okay, where are you? Ah. Oh, okay. Well, interesting. He updated on the move. All right. So we have a few Stuart tanks here. We need a whole bunch more. So there's that. There's that armored brigade. There's this armored brigade that we set for... We'll turn this one off so that we only get one at a time. Might as well let the other one fill up first. Any other units that arrived? We're still trying to update the heavy artillery, the heavy anti-aircraft artillery. Oh, here's the Indian Brigade. Oh, we're using her. This is not here yet. We're using her engineers. Rangoon stays up at 22.215. I take that as a real accomplishment, keeping her in the fight. Empress of Scotland, I believe, has delivered, or is delivering supplies. It disband after. And also a fighter squadron. Fantastic. The first Hawk Hurricane 2s. Let's try, how far can we transfer her? Oh, nowhere. Oops, she's still being dismantled at the moment. So you'll notice that even when she's in transit, look at her, she's how did she get any training? Well, she didn't fly, right? But even in transit, because she was on training mission, her pilots managed to increase sometime during the week, or actually just yesterday, the green marker. There's another unholy traffic jam at Karachi. Okay. We need to dock the tankers because they need the dock facilities most badly in order to get their fluids off. Next, we still have room. We'll take the two slowest ones. Oh, what else is there? Now we can take the big ones. All right, now we're jammed up here. Unloading, making sure we're going to stay here. Okay, unloading and disband. So that's another 10,000, 13,000 supply and fuel. Fantastic. No, we're building it. Notice how much we're dropping and how it's just disappearing because it's being drawn across the country on by the rail. Oh, there's Abadan filled up and emptied out. That's great. No tankers, no AO. So we'll go with the AKs, the transports. We'll load the largest one. Dock Now we'll transfer in the smaller ones. Wow. Sure doesn't take much to fill up this dock, does it? We have 16,000 and 48,000 here, so we're going to start off giving priority to supplies. We'll suck the supplies dry and then pick up fuel. Still no ships in Aden to pick up those units. Another unit has arrived, a three convoy. City of Canterbury. Now, where were these guys? Load supplies. I think we're going to send these. I should keep track, better track of these, but I don't. We'll try to send them to Sydney. Okay, let's watch for the waypoints to disappear. Use waypoints. Somewhere out here. Like that. Let's hope that works. Any mid-ocean traffic? Here comes one heading for Cochin. It's three. It's got, okay. Another city of Exeter. We missed sending out an escort. We won't miss this time. Let's form surface combat. We'll send, oh, it's what we got. Corvettes. Here goes another one. Supply convoy. Here's 40,000 for bound for Calcutta. Tumulo. Is holding well, but she's surrounded and the Japanese are chasing the Australians down the track. At least we're burning up the supply. There's only 20,000 left out of what we almost had with 60. We went up to 100, then we pulled them out. We better start thinking about evacuation. The HDML motor launch here. We're going to form up. Let's see if we can't sneak past down to Kopang. Turn off. Do not suck their fuel dry if you can. Yeah, only 600 here. Our ships are still trying to pump out. They got just a little bit out. The enemy attacked Ternate last turn. One was damaged. Was it Ternate or Manando? Maybe both. This is the Navy patrol squadron, not a Dutch patrol squadron. Seal is still trying to dig them out of Davao. Wait, why are we running all PT boat, mister? Why are we running all the way up here there when there's a clear the patrol zone when there's a enemy squadron right down here? Okay, now we'll set the home base for Bataan. Yes, we'll head out, see if we can't fire a few more torpedoes into these transports. Princessa Puerto Princesa manages to repair. Oh, where shall we fly? Oh, we could get all the way down. We can go all the way to Ambon. Sor Baja. These kingfishers have some great range. Let's go to Ambon and evacuate that route. Ambon is on Papua New Guinea. At Darwin, we're still unloading tankers. So we'll shove these into the base. Any other ships? Yeah. Wow, how did we... That must be one hell of a large tanker. Okay, we'll get rid of that one. Grab another tanker. Try to unload. Some of the transports are empty. Okay. We're dropping them in to the town while we wait for the rest. The unit has arrived at Catherine, and I'm having second thoughts about using 100 points. It's 2 days worth of political points collection. So in the grand scheme of things, 100 points isn't very much, but it could be somewhat dear at this point in time. I'm going to hold, especially since these fighters aren't really that necessary. These level bombers, whatnot, I'm keeping them, trying to keep the points out of the enemy's hands. I'm just being petty about it. We could always withdraw them, and that would prevent the enemy from capturing them. They would never come back, and we would never have any use of them for them afterwards. So it's not like the enemy would get the points for these. So I'm just trying to be... parsimonious, I guess, niggardly with my begrudging the enemy any victory points. The enemy has seized Brunei. Not good. And we're still sailing around out here trying to penetrate. The aircraft that are useful are these Dornier. These flying boats, but that's only in the beginning. There aren't any replacements, or so having them, spending 100 points to get them, if it was getting something cheap, that's one thing. But spending a lot to get a little doesn't really make sense. The enemy is on top of Makassar. So let's see how far we can transfer these. Looks like we have to go Ambon. Ambon's right over here. Okay. Ambon it is. They may be making a landing on Makassar, so they're cutting off any chance of escape for these fighters. We are too short ranged, but the flying boats can get out. So the question is, the flying boat range is, heck, 54. You could fly all the way down to close to what here, 50 Townsville, almost Townsville, Cairns, or there's an interesting point. The flying boats will not land in Catherine because they're boats, hence need water. I don't want to give 600 points up for Darwin, but if we gave him, say, Cooktown as a temporary base, or possibly Normanton but as a temporary base, there's a railroad. No, there isn't a railroad to Normanton. There isn't a railroad to Cooktown either. So both would be isolated from supply. Let me think. Would that be worthwhile? Even if we gathered 30 or 40 flying boats here, that would be incredible coverage of this area. Very, very thick coverage of this area. For as long as the boats lasted, until they crashed or outrun down from lack of maintenance. While we don't have a lot of Catalinas, it would free up our Catalinas to operate in other areas. So I'm going to see if I can't get maybe Cooktown switched over to Cooktown Cooktown over to Australia, American, British, Dutch, Australian base. All right, I see how I'll do it. There's a unit here, 21st Company. It's already a American, British, Dutch, Australian, or I don't know what the order, Australian, British, Dutch, American. She's a very small unit, air transportable. So what we're going to do is 2nd of the 1st Company, 1st Independent Company, we're going to use the flying boats again. Troop transport. We could also click down here. If you knew which one was down here, you could always click on this one. There. That's A Company. Where is that? 2nd of the 1st Indian Company. You can click directly down here. And it'll... troop transport. Yeah, 2nd of the 1st. Oh, and then you just move back and forth, and it's there. It's selected. So you have to do that little select click, and then you can click on it. We're going to send it over to Cooktown, and we'll put all the patrols on it. It's not a big deal, but we'll go slowly. The Empire boats don't have very many replacements, and we don't have a lot. We can't update them to Catalinas. So once they're gone, they're kind of gone. I'm going to put this Catalina back on search, because knowing where the enemy is more important than moving that right now. We're worried that he might be coming down this way already. We can hold him here. We have 160. We're building. We've got 400 over here. There's no way he's going to beat that. Even though he's upgraded some of these, there's still not enough. What we have here is we've got a bunch of supply ships. First things first, I'm going to get the supply ships out of the way. We're going to put them all into the disband them into the base so they cannot be targets. There's two gunboats that cannot. Because they're only loaded with supplies, we can push them right into the base. Unfortunately, the ones with troops on them cannot. So I'm going to have to take the biggest one with troops here. Okay, we'll take the biggest 2, 3. We're going to dock these. We'll keep unloading. Set for disband. I'll transfer in anything else with troops. No, nothing else will fit with troops on here. I'm going to put one gunboat with them. I don't know how the AI chooses its targets, whether they will be allowed to attack it. The others will continue just to load, unload over the beach best they can. With the cruiser standing by. I still don't want to release the cruisers to go herring off. I don't know if it should. If that's the case, if it makes it better for these to be chasing these guys. But they're only destroyers so far. If the enemy tries... there's a battleship. I think this is misidentification. It's probably a couple of cruisers. CS is a seaplane cruiser. and the heavy cruiser could be, maybe a couple of light cruisers, destroyers. The battleships are, I bet, transports. I don't think he's cruising around here with a battleship. We've got Banshees bombing. Right now, I don't need this extra Warhawk section. So what I'm going to do is we're going to come down a little bit altitude-wise. I'm going to send this one back to the one with lesser planes. I'm going to send it back to Port Moresby for combat air patrol. Not necessary. I don't think he can attack it. But that means I can bring up this other Banshee squadron. That's what I want. We're setting naval attack. Search. Let's get it over to Rabaul. We've had some damage on the cruisers. They've expended. I couldn't believe one stupid little destroyer got in and did this much damage. Really? One destroyer. Okay, we've fired off the torpedoes, but we still have pretty good main gun armament. Over here, no offense. Here are the ships. The same here. How could they get so close? He sailed right into the task force. Either my guys are blind or we got some real problems here. Okay, we've used up some of the sorties. These are the bombs that carried. So, okay. Could it be that my Dauntlesses are flying too high on the search in order to search properly? So I'm going to use the... We did send the Devastators. Okay, all torpedo bombers in this hex are going to fly at the lower altitude, 5,000. And I'm also going to order to change the planes. Instead of 2,000, might be good for submarines, but maybe they're not good enough for all float planes on ships in this hex are going to be at 5,000. 5,000 is generally, I think, a better spotting altitude. My worry is these guys are going to be calling in the carriers, and if they call in the carriers, we could be in some big doo-doo. Especially since I'm so darned blind to everything. Okay, we're still setting a merge here. Almost unloaded. Okay, this one's unloaded. Transfer into the base. And the other one, oh yeah, we're unloading at a rate of 2 support squads per day. That's how we got the last one here. Great. Or maybe that's 2 per phase. No, 2 per day, I think it is. This one, it's just not going to get that sound detector off. And the field guns. So either we sit here and wait until the base builds up and then they drop off, or we sail away and come back for it later. Another tough decision to be made. Just as disturbing is, what the hell are destroyers doing here? We killed one here. Two here, I think. What the hell are they heading for the Elise Islands, or are they heading for Suva? If the AI has chosen a script to head for Suva, we better start building some fortifications right now. We've dropped off the Rarotonga. Detachment. I'm going to send them over to Nandi. Nandi has a Catalina squadron helping search there. It won't do much. We'll see them coming. We just won't be able to stop them coming. Still unloading. Almost at Penryn. 2 more days. In the Midway area, the enemy seems to have run off, so we'll do like Mr. Mao says. Enemy retreats, we advance to unload. We have a mission here. You're not going to stop us. We're at 39%. The units almost are there. We're almost out of fuel. Now, because we're carrying AKEs, AKEs are the ammunition ships for replenishing battleships and carriers in port, helping assist that. So we don't want to be unloading when we get here. We just want to disband into the base. Next turn, I'll form up and then I'll take these things out. But I don't want to separate them because of the submarine threat. Here we are approaching the transport group, another transport group. So it's almost like playing a game of ball, you playing catch. The pitcher here throws the convoy out to about here. We catch the convoy here and bring it into the islands. We've loaded one, almost, we'll load the other soon, okay? And this one, oh jeez, jeez Louise, what a pathetic example. All right. Oh, another ship has appeared. Okay. We're staying far offshore. We'll go into the catching area. Hey, why not? We will hitch a ride with these guys. Set, meet, and greet. Merge. Beautiful. Get a battleship escort. Here's the carrier. She was attacked, defended herself barely, and got home. These are the yard patrol. They were out. Here are the tankers. Loading, transferring the full one back into the port. You know, we've got extra. I'm going to form up a escort group. Let's try escort. We'll form up with the yard patrol, sending them forth to merge. Oops. Incompatible. Okay. Escort. When dealing with a carrier, I'm going to be a little bit cautious, so even if we get close, we're going to send them off to pull in. No other ships here. The Queen Elizabeth is waiting and raring to go. I could send her off. I mean, she could carry most of this infantry division here. Most of it, if not all. The 27th. We could buy it. We'll rebuild. The 27th is worth, we could move it into one of these. So 1,200 maybe, 1/4 is what, 300, 320 points? We could buy it. We could buy it and send it. But right now, time-wise, I think it might be more prudent to buy and spend the Australian units just because they're closer. Oh, here we are. There's the Bishopdale. Let's form up the escort group. We'll take the little ones, the ones without any fuel left. We'll take the big ones. We're going to form, we'll transfer the ones without any, with limited fuel. We'll send these into the base. We don't want to rob any more fuel from these guys. Australia. Okay. And we'll send the Bishop Bale out of here. Replenish from sea. Disband. These are the large ones. We can continue unloading them. Just so we have a fresh start next turn. I think, we don't need the Gorgon. The Bishopdale. I think it's better to keep her fueled. We could send her for more gas. But if a large group comes in, okay. Sure, we'll unload it. We'll send the Bishopdale. She's such a large ship. We'll send her for more fuel afterwards. Okay, we'll unload it. Because a port can only refuel so many ships at a time. If there's a large task force that comes through that needs it, then the Bishopdale can take up that slack. But I don't foresee any large group coming through that need gas that badly that quickly. Even the carrier group here, if it needs gas, it can grab it, but there's no hurry. It can wait another day to load a second time, if that's the case. Let's say in the north, let's get this damn, okay. All right, you stupid bastard. Load. We're gonna sit here and load until you give us everything. Jeez. The other ships? Oh, we're still unloading. Man, oh. Was it because I failed to lock? No. I didn't tell it to unload. Can you believe that? Okay. How much more is left here? It's not insignificant. Should we just send the ships? Yes, I'm going to send the ships for them now. We don't need the... What happened? Oh, well, we have the armed merchant cruisers. They aren't the best ships in the world. This is the only one that has a depth charge rack on it. Let's hope we'll get out and back before a sub-threat appears. We sent the yard patrol minesweepers down south. I may have to call some... Yeah, here they are. Here are some of them. This should be the last mission. Once we pull these back in, I don't foresee too many missions out here. Unless something pops up that we need to go grab it. A Marine Raider Battalion has appeared in the eastern... Okay. We're sending him down to San Francisco. My mistake. This stupid thing here, because it's a transport, won't allow the... We'll transfer in Yard Patrol. There we go. Doing our final turn check, we call use the A hotkey to call up the aircraft and do the usual sort according to patrol and see that there's something at flying at 40 over an Aden, so we know that it's a new reinforcement that I've missed. Not a big deal. He's training at 40. No reinforcements needed. We'll train him at 100 low altitude. I've mentioned it a few times, but training at low altitude, you get the bombing training as well as the defensive value to protect your aircraft. Oh yeah, good thing I checked back on these Banshees. I forgot to increase their range to 8, so we now have them. There's also a landing at Madang. Damn it. So we've spotted it. Madang is within range of 8, so these Banshees are going into attack mode as well. This is the headquarters squadron, I guess. We can hold up to 4. The flying boats combined together all count as 1, I think. 1. And this I think this Warhawk doesn't count because it's a fragment. I think they're all counted together. So 1. We have the Hudsons on search. Let's have them on naval attack. Here's the Horn Island detachment evacuated. We're going to pull them up here to join up with their mates. to unload that silly sound detector. So, everyone remind me, you can pick up a sound detector off a level 1 base hex. All right. Let's try to remember that. Let me try to remember that, damn it. Sea Lion fires at torpedoes. Duds. Sir, oh! The Nagata comes in and kits it right in the kisser. 7 hits. But she also gets some damage. Gives some damage. Submarine attack. Salmon fires 2 more duds. Sea Dragon fire. No, misses. Salmon fires. Duds. Oh, a loaded transport. Night attack, Singapore. Nothing. Okay, that's a pretty significant attack force, so we'll have to fly something at night to protect against it. Davao. Oh, another sub-attack, Laog, 2 more torpedoes fired, duds. Salmon fires, duds. Spearfish fires, duds. Holy cow! KV-7 fire, a hit! See, the Dutch subs do not suffer from duds. Air attack, Kuala Lumpur. The fortresses return the favor on Vigan. No hits. Air attack, the Bettys on the task force near Rabaul. Right, this is the bait. Draw them in. Kill the bombers. Uh-oh, the harbor defense... holy cow, they wasted 2 torpedoes on it. Air attack, Hanover Island. The Banshees get in on it. Air attack, Bettys. 2 more destroyed. Air attack, Kukong. Kansien troops bombed. Air attack, Chusien. Is it the base? Yes. And there goes that supply again. Air attack, Manado. We have the Catalina squadron there. Air attack, Ternate. There goes our evacuation route. Air attack, Davao. Wow, he's got carriers everywhere. Air attack, Manila. But this time we got fighters. 7 destroyed. Air attack, Wuchao on troops at Wuchao. Troops at Changsha attacked. Hudson's attack. A transport group missed. Banshees attack. Bomb! Battleship Issei bombed! Uh-oh. We better watch this one. Battleship bombed! Yamashiro. Troops at Yinan bombed. Spearfish fires. Duds. Pickerel fires. 2 hits! Loaded transport. Sea Lion fire. No. Sea Lion evades. Ternate being invaded. Shock attack. Davao. Heavy defender casualties. Deliberate attack. Chusien. 1 to 127. Heavy Japanese casualties, moderate Allied casualties. The important ones, 19 squads destroyed and 12 guns destroyed, not disabled. Ground attack, Anyang. Assault 1 to 52. The Japanese wrecked themselves in the attack. Look at those losses. Almost a banzai attack. Bombardment Quay Sui. Mulo attacked 1 to 12 odds. Moderate casualties to the Japanese. Bombardment Davao. Deliberate attack Anyang, 16 to 1. Anyang captured. Two units retreat. Heavy casualties. Light Chinese casualties. Retreating towards Kaifeng. Excellent. Now, because that's important to know when we chase them in there next turn.